We've never faced a threat like this before. We need video game expertise. These guys were champions back in 82.
Sam Brenner, Pac-Man World Champion.
What's up?
Ludlow Lemonsoft, Master of Centipede.
Also known as...
Your worst nightmare!
Eddie Plant, King of Donkey Kong.
We know that Tom Cruise maybe saved our planet from aliens just about like 211 times.
He's but good at it. He's yeah, very
he
good
is,
at
thank
it.
God. Thank God. But it's a first for you, isn't it?
What well, the feel first like that the they captured on watch? Film. The first they captured on film. Right. I've done this so many times. I've saved Russia many times. I've saved about 12 times. It's just I do it so quietly, and so I'm not doing it to get the pat on the back. I'm doing it just to make sure everybody's cool.
And finally, it came with 3D cameras. And
then, yeah, I got talked adventure. Into it. Please let us shoot one of these. And I was like, you know, these video games are going to come alive and try to kill us all. If you guys want to get that, get you know, film it, I'm fine with that. And they did, and it turned out great.
What does it feel like to be the unlikely saviors of humanity?
It feels right.
Yeah.
About time.
I don't think we're unlikely. I think that most people, when they look at Peter and I, would say
just
yes.
Think those are the guys we should
yes.
trust.
Forget yeah. about Thor. Forget about Spider-Man. You're looking at Tyrion Lannister and Olaf.
Yeah.
These two guys know
what's
what
the nice
do.
Change from the dirt and misery of Game of Thrones mm. latest season?
Yes, we went dark. Shock.
Don't tell anybody I killed the Smurf.
What did you find most challenging when creating those characters exactly, bringing them onto big screen? And was it from really challenging from a technological point of view?
Well, from a technology point of view, in terms of making sure that they interacted, because I still think it's a mistake to make every film, all the sequences, all CGI. So we needed to take these sequences, like we shot the car chase for Pac-Man, all practically involved with the actors. We literally built the Donkey Kong set so the actors mm-hmm. could be harnessed and jump over what would eventually become CGI barrels. And to get those barrels and Donkey Kong and Pac-Man to interact mm-hmm. with our environment, our realistic environment, was the biggest challenge.
It was hard to let it go. You'd come home at night and you'd still think, you know, Donkey Kong was trying to destroy you. And, you know, my kids would go in the other room while I was screaming, leave me alone. Just let me eat my food, man.
Do they understand the whole frenzy about Pac-Man and all
the
that?
Pac-Man is bananas, how everybody knows Pac-Man. Every age, every country, it's pretty crazy.
I was just thinking maybe like the younger generation needs to be reintroduced to
I don't think they need
are.
To be reintroduced. I thought right. that too. But like my kids, 9 and 6, and their friends come over and they all know Pac-Man. They have Pac-Man parties out in California right now. One of my kids had a birthday party and they were all playing Pac-Man.
May I introduce to you the creator of Pac-Man?
Professor Iwatani, what are you doing?
I will talk to him. He's my son. Hello, my sweet little boy. Look how big you've grown.
It's so sweet. He's so sweet.
You're a good boy. Ah!
Somebody kill this stupid thing!
To watch all the newest and hottest interviews first, please subscribe to my channel.